Welcome back to the channel. I want to show you guys how to do some keyframing on a secondary node. So here we have this shot. I'll play it back for you. And what I did was raise up the shadows as the penguin moves toward the darker part of the shot. So I'll play it with the secondary node off. So then here, by the time it gets to about here, you can see we've brightened it up quite a bit. On the first node, we just did a little bit of primary balancing, and on the second one, I brought it up, as opposed to this node is pretty much completely off at the start of the shot. So let's take a look at the keyframes. Went ahead and chose node number 2, and down here, you can see it says corrector 2, and I went to right about where I wanted it to start fading in, and just selected a keyframe. In this case, I just grabbed the gain, moved it down one, and then back up. That made a keyframe, and then I went to the end of my shot, and I just raised the shadows up. That's about 55. So now we have a dynamic keyframe in here, where if we watch the scopes, it gradually rises up as we get into the shadow here. So let's pull back to about here. You can see where the black level is sitting, and then as we make our way further into the shot, it slowly raises up. It's a little less noticeable since it's over such a long period of time. That's how you can add a dynamic keyframe on a secondary node and leave all your primary color corrections. All right, thanks for watching as always, and I'll talk to you guys on the next one.